Hey, I'm Dinis. Welcome to my channel DMaker. This video is the last video of the do-it-yourself table saw series. If you haven't seen the first three parts yet, I strongly recommend you to check them out. This time I will be showing you some improvements to the build as well as how I made the crosscut sled, which is a very useful accessory. I will also explain in detail the five cut method to make the fence of the sled perfectly square with the blade. Let's get into it. After using my table saw for a while, I realized that because of the vibrations produced by the motor, the fixing knob for the tilting system was not enough to keep the blade in its position after a long cutting session. So I decided to make a locking pin, and for that I used an 8mm stainless steel rod. I attached a keychain ring to the rod in order to be able to pull it. To make sure the blade was exactly at 90 degrees with the tabletop, I used a magnetic digital protector. After setting the blade at 90 degrees, I made a hole through the structure and put the pin in place. I did the exact same procedure off camera for the 45 degrees angle. The second improvement I did was in the locking mechanism in the rear end of the fence. I found out that when tightening this knob, it might happen that the fence moves slightly to the sides. So I decided to keep using the knob, but with an additional piece of plywood with some rubber in it. Now, every time I tighten the knob, the fence won't slide to the sides and it will be completely fixed. Next thing that was missing in the table saw was the sliding rails. The rails are essential so that you can use all types of sleds and jigs. For the rails, I used a U-shaped aluminum profile and made the groove for it using a router and a thread bit. After drilling and countersinking the holes in the profile, I used wood screws to fix the rails in the tabletop. After all the improvements, it's now time to make the crosscut sled. For the sled, I used 10mm MDF, and as runners I used a squared aluminum profile that has the same width as the inside of the rails. I decided to reinforce the squared profile by inserting a strip of 10mm MDF inside. The sled is 80 cm long and 60 cm wide.
I marked the location of the runners in the sled and attached them temporarily using screws. After testing if it runs okay, I marked the exact location with an X-Acto knife and removed the runners to make a slight groove where they will sit. To make the fence, I used two pieces of 18mm Baltic birch plywood bound together and two smaller pieces of pine in the front and back to reinforce. The pieces of plywood had a slight arch in them, so I connected them with the concave part against each other. And I used a straight edge when gluing them together to make sure the fence was completely straight. Due to some sliding while gluing, the two pieces of plywood got misaligned, so I trimmed them a little bit on the table saw to make them flush. I then shaped the pieces of solid wood in the bandsaw, rounded the edges in the router, and finished them using some files and sandpaper. In order to be able to use a stopper for repetitive cuts, I decided to mount a T-track on the top of the fence. Unfortunately, the stopper I bought was not big enough to be used on this sled, so I had to machine a new piece off camera made out of 21mm Baltic birch plywood. I then glued the two pieces of pine to the fence and reinforced the connection with wood screws. As for the main fence, I just used two screws, one on each end, exactly 68 cm apart. You'll see later in the video why I had to make this with such precision. I made the initial cut in the sled, but I forgot to change the blade to a crosscut blade, so I had a bit of splinter in the wood. To make the fence perfectly square with the blade, I used the 5-cut method that I will explain shortly. Please skip this part if you think that's not necessary. I will make 4 cuts, one on each side of a piece of MDF, and then a 5th cut in the same side as the first. This way, the error will sum up each time I make a cut. The first cut should be made preferably in the longer side of the piece, and after making the first cut, I can already see that the fence is not exactly 90 degrees with the blade. I then make a second cut, putting the first side against the fence, and repeat the process for the third and fourth cut. After making the fifth cut, I measure the width of the leftover at the top and at the bottom. If they are the same, it means that the fence is perfectly square with the blade. But this is not the case. Then I subtract these two numbers and divide them by 4. This will be divided by the length of the remaining piece to get the error per distance. And finally, this is multiplied by the distance between the pivoting point and the adjusting point of the fence. This number represents the distance that the fence should move. If the number is positive, the right side of the fence should come forward, and if it's negative, should go backwards. In this case, the fence should move 4.62 mm forward. I used a piece of plywood that was 4.4 mm thick, together with a filler gauge with 0.22 mm. I move the fence and fix it with a screw, this time using a different hole. I made a test cut and it's spot on. The fence is perfectly square with the blade. After making sure the fence is perpendicular, I reinforce the connection with more wood screws. I can now test the sled with a stopper by using a small piece of MDF. The final result is pretty good, and the dimensions were calculated so that the sled fits perfectly in the bottom of the table saw cabinet.
The crosscut sled is a really helpful accessory, and in my opinion, a must-have in any workshop. It allows you to safely make cross cuts in the table saw, and it's particularly helpful with small stock. Well, that's all for the do-it-yourself table saw series, but there are still plenty of accessories and jigs that can be done to improve the efficiency and safety of the table saw. I will cover some of them in future videos, so please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to get all the notifications. Thanks for watching, and remember, you can build it!